I'm sure you're asking yourself what the Academy of Arts building, inaugurated in 2005 with its modern glass facade, could have to do with the history of the Third Reich in Berlin. On the photograph, you see its predecessor, the Arnim Palace. When located there during the Weimar Republic, the Academy had already experienced an enormous boom. Artists such as Lovis Corinth, Georg Kolber and Käthe Kollwitz brought renown under the president Max Liebermann. However, this came to an end after the Reichstag election in March 1933. 40 members, including the famous authors Heinrich and Thomas Mann, were forced to resign or were barred from the institution. In 1937, the Academy, which was not highly regarded by the National Socialists, was required to hand the building over completely to the General Building Inspector, who set up his office there. Albert Speer justified the choice of location in that Hitler could quickly and safely walk from the Reich Chancellery through the ministerial gardens to the palace. For Hitler's visits, models and plans for rebuilding Berlin into the world capital were set up in the exhibition halls on the ground floor. As early as 1931, the young architect Speer had become a member of the Nazi Party, and in 1932 he was entrusted with smaller commissions from within Goebbels' circle. Starting in 1933, he made a name for himself with Hitler as equipment propaganda choreographer, with temporary stages, decorative banners and lighting on the occasion of the rallies on May the 1st and the Nuremberg rallies. He soon became part of Hitler's closest circle and was named the Führer's architect. In 1936, he thus began working on the first designs for a radical reconstruction of Berlin, which is now known as Germania Project. With a Führer decree symbolically issued on January the 30th, 1937, the anniversary of the National Socialists' accession to power, Hitler appointed Speer General Building Inspector, or GBI, of the Reich capital. From then on, he carried authority similar to a minister, a power which he developed consciously and increasingly. Thus, the GBI took measures and made arrangements to ensure a homogeneous cityscape. Around half of the urban area was declared an area of interest. Among other authority, Speer's institution had the right of veto for all buildings, streets and parks. Not only private contractors, but also Reich authorities, the state of Prussia and the Reich capital had to answer to the GBI. This led to conflicts in the city administration in Berlin. When, in July 1940, the Lord Mayor Julius Lippert, who was well networked in the Nazi Party, refused to accept unilateral instructions from the GBI, Speer had him immediately dismissed. The GBI organised the demolition of entire city districts in order to make room through the cityscape for the two major Axis projects, 53,000 flats housing for 150,000 people were to be torn down. The already existing housing shortage in Berlin therefore became even more critical. Karl Maria Hettlager, Speer's specialist in questions of administration, worked out an infamous solution. Jews were registered in a file system and evicted from their homes. Their empty flats were then offered to what the Nazis called Aryan citizens, who had been affected by forced displacement due to Speer's remodelling plans. Gestapo deportation lists, which were later used to deport Berlin Jews to extermination camps, were created from this registry. During the war, the GBI's office was also responsible for planning, authorising and building around 3,000 forced labour camps in Greater Berlin, 70 of which it personally operated. Even before Speer became Minister of Armaments and War Production in 1942, his actions already demonstrated a disastrous amalgamation with the murderous logic of National Socialism. This reveals his hypocrisy when he presented himself later as an apolitical technocrat and misled idealist. He developed this strategy during the Nuremberg war crimes trials in 1945-1946, thus escaping capital punishment. In his autobiography, published in 1969 after he had served his 20-year sentence, he maintained this deceitful myth of his own creation. Do you like this video clip? Please subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.